My name is Armen, and I'm coming from Armenia. So today was like many questions. Are you actually coming from Armenia to take a part of this? So the answer is yes. So it's three flights in 24 hours. So thank you, John, for having us here. And the Armenian gang, they are from Armenian American University from Armenia. So one of my favorite slides that Zuckerberg very clearly explained how we are sharing the content. So it was saying like 10 years ago, we were sharing the text messages because our phones were capable to do so. Then the 5 years later, we started to share photos, and now is the era of the video. That's why everyone is on the TikTok, lives on the Instagram, and wherever. And the next 5 years is gonna be about the content sharing in AR and VR. So what it means, we will capture or we will share the AR experience so others can see, or we can share the VR experience and somebody can be, like more Armenians could be here sitting with us. So according to the research, the key technology for the Gen Z is gonna be AR and VR. So, and this is message to all of us that we have to be prepared. We have to create the educational, we have to create the art and the entertainment and many other things for them in this format. Otherwise, they're not gonna use it, they're not gonna get it. So if we will check the current generation, they are more in the videos. So they are on the YouTube, they are watching videos, and they are consuming the content in the video format. That says we have to be prepared for the next. So that's in having in mind, we have created the Arlupa app. You are welcome to download it. Today we had a lot of fun, a lot of AR components with the stage. So this is, we are calling like a Swiss knife, Swiss Army knife, because it's incorporating all sorts of AR, mobile AR, under one shelf. One project that we did specially, it's kind of like a test that we did for the Gen Z to see how this works. And this project get like more than 5,000 views. It's a street art that we converted to AR. Let's look how this looks like. We hope it will play. Yep. Could you please increase the volume? So you can imagine many like youngsters was coming here. It's next to the museum of Aram Khachatryan. They are coming there especially to see this magic wall that is coming alive and playing the music. So this gives us the message that the content that we have creating for them, the content should be good enough that their parents will be happy to pay for that content, because they will their kids still will use the smartphones, but they will not use the games. They don't like the parents especially, but instead they will use the content. So this is the project from the Wonderscope. I will shortly show you, will get an idea how we see the next content should be. It should be interactive with the voice recognition, of course. And this app is currently offering in-app purchase options.
Oh, good, you're here. We better get going now. Grandma has a lot of seeds for us to plant.
Can I touch it? That's cool.
What if you fall?
What you got there?
I'll get crushed to death by the thousands of tons of water.
Oh, look at that.
That's crashing down below me.
Yeah. age ain't nothing but a number.
Here we go. Time.
So you get an idea. So this is a lot of social component where the parents can interact with their kids. They can play and learn in the same environment. And this is the type of content that we are thinking should be created and monetized. The other example is from the Magic Leap. Today we had our colleagues here. They were sharing about the platform, how to create on that platform. And I think there is no doubt that students in a school age will be just happy to have such lessons where they can immersively learn and can see the different experiences in front of them. Having that in mind, we have created our own library, and we are inviting the artists to work with us to create the valuable, high quality, polished content that we hope will be monetized. So our primary focus is art, education, and entertainment. I want to show one example that this happens with us like 2 years ago. This is actually my profile, and it was before the new year. One of our colleagues were staying at the office. It was late night, last days of the year. We're saying, okay, it's finished. We are all going to home. And Hajak, who is like the father of our Loop app, he was saying, I'm finishing something. I will finish it and then we'll go to home. So late night, I get this video. So it was not like finally polished. You can see there is no shadows, etc. But I realized that this is kind of like atomic bomb. And I was not able to hold myself to not posting it on the social media. So next morning when I wake up, there was about like 500 shares. Then after a month, you can see it was like 5,000 shares only from my profile. Then the other pages started to copy and share on their own. And you can see the 3 million views only on Arte Longa page. And overall, it was 10 million views without spending $0. So this gives us an idea that the valuable content have the chance to be monetized. Because if the people love it, if they're sharing, they care it, the only thing that we have to do is to create the valuable content. And recently, the Microsoft announced the new type of content, which is volumetric capture. And it's really a lot of excitement around it. Because before, there was a problem with the avatars. There was not looking natural. It's called Uncanny Valley, where people are seeing the avatars which are not real, and they are starting to afraid and don't like it. But look what's the Microsoft Capture Studio, Microsoft Mixed Reality Studio is able to get it. One more time, please. Platform now supports these volumetric captures. There are three studios which are doing these captures and our app is supporting. On the next update, we will have this type of content available in the app. But you can imagine how immersive and cool could be the experience having like many different type of art shows, like our favorite singers can appear in our environment. And there is a lot of excitement around it. So currently we're already supporting this store concept so the creative people can come over and can start selling actually their content, their stories, their games, whatever. And of course we are understanding that the next transition is from the mobile to the glasses. And like as we are building on the Unity platform, the transition is going to be really smooth and easy for us to support all these kind of glasses. So currently our focus is the content because we're understanding that the king thing is the content. So whoever will own the most of the content and high quality of the content, the glass maker is gonna come to them. It's an Apple or whoever. So this is another idea that we are committed to do this year in Armenia. We want to reconstruct one of the most famous places in Armenia. The GIF is playing too fast. It's not supposed to play this fast, but you will get an idea. And the concept is to try to get the interested people to fund such a project and to become shareholders. So it's a pretty easy. You are funding the project, or you're collectively funding the project. And then whatever is sold, you are getting the 70%. It's similar to the App Store. When you're uploading the app there, and whatever you are getting, the Apple is keeping 30% and giving 70%. So this is what we are implementing right now. Thank you for your time, and thank you for staying this long. Really appreciate it.